Hey guys, it's Holly. So today I have a very vintage Harry Potter set review for you that is also one of the weirdest line of sets that LEGO ever released. So a couple of months ago, I got sent a very special set to my PO box, and that is actually set 4722, which was the sort of original Gryffindor common room. Now, if you guys are not familiar with these sets, there was a line of like three of them. There was like a potions classroom, there was like Diagon Alley shops, and the Gryffindor common room. And this one in particular is the Gryffindor common room. What I also love about this set is that this one's actually a Sorcerer's Stone set, which doesn't say a Philosopher's Stone, which makes it extra special because it came from the US. So they were like these little sets with like cardboard, and to me they always felt very targeted towards girls and sort of like a dollhouse type of thing. So I want to take a look at it today. But before we do, I just want to say a big shout out to Aaron for sending me this to my PO box in order to review it and sort of add it to my collection. It's now officially my oldest LEGO Harry Potter set, and I'm very, very excited. Thank you so much for this, and also thank you so much for the card. So here's the set all built up, and this is one of three very sort of weird, I almost feel like as well, just targeted towards young girls and things like that type of set, with all these bright colors and just interesting builds and paperbacks. And this one specifically is meant to represent the Gryffindor common room. Now these sets were quite small and just a very unique and very, very odd. So let's start off and have a look at the minifigure first. So our one and only minifigure in this set is Ron Weasley in sort of these nice casual robes. Now, just like the original wave of Harry Potter sets, he's got one of those star capes with that giant copyright symbol in the bottom corner, which is just classic. This cape as well is in incredibly great condition, which I am incredibly happy with. Also, just the torso print in general really just shows its age. It is incredibly sort of low cut, very basic, very minimal lines, and just overall very simple detailing. He's also got some of those old grey legs lying around, which is pretty neat, as well as the original Ron Weasley face in yellow, which had sort of an interesting face print to it. I mean, he looks kind of cheeky, also looks incredibly old, and has this really awful sort of coconut bowl haircut piece, which is a really nice shade of orange, honestly. It's a lot different to the orange that we'd usually get these days for ginger hair, but it matches his eyebrows really easily, and there's not much else to this figure. There's no back printing, no double-sided head. It's just very, very simple and very neat and tidy. So the first thing I want to have a look at in this set is this weird cardboard backing that you get. So it sort of just lies flat like that inside of the box, and it sort of gives you just this really odd looking backdrop. You pop it up like that, and then all of a sudden you've got these like three little sections here. You've got a side here with the fireplace as well as the Gryffindor banner and just the little hallway, and then on the other end you have more so the Gryffindor dormitory, completely decked out with some wizard hats and some cloaks, and it just looks very, very old-timey. And you can really tell that this was made in 2001, just purely based on the art style of the thing. Now, this is a pretty rare piece these days. I'm pretty sure not many people really have them lying around, and it really makes up a lot of sort of the content and value with these weird type of like little dollhouse style sets. Now, the first room that's included in this set is more so the Gryffindor common room, and these are all just very basic builds that are built up on an 8x8 square plate, and then they've got these incredibly bright colours. I feel like this is what Friends was before Friends was even a thing. You have this fat lady portrait here, which just clips into this weird archway piece and can be spun around. However, this one is missing the little clip at the top, so it doesn't quite fit into that gap perfectly and work just as well as it should have. I will need to try and order a replacement for that one, but you can see that it sort of turns around and allows you to sort of access the Gryffindor common room, as well as display this little fire build on the opposite side of this little frame piece here. Next to it is this very rather large version of an orange chair here, which gives you three studs in order to stick a minifigure on, which is pretty neat. I'm glad that it sort of gives them somewhere to sit. However, with the cape, it doesn't quite fit as nicely as you'd probably expect. So you've sort of got to drape it over the back here and just slot down the minifigure like so. There's some flowers as well on the armrest just to give it a little bit more pizzazz. And then in front of the chair, you get a matching orange table with a teal bottom, a nice pink translucent cup, as well as this little lamp build. And on the top, you're supposed to place this little book, which on the inside has a 1x2 transparent blue tile, which just has a bunch of little stars on them, which is a pretty neat print, honestly. The build, though, really doesn't give you all too much space or really things to do or move around in. There's not too many play features, but that fat lady print is really cool and really interesting. And her face is honestly kind of a bit scary. And then to top it all off, there is a dark blue owl at the top. And then the other part of this build is the Gryffindor common room. And firstly, with this little section, you do get this red trunk as well as this translucent blue wand piece, which really just looks like a half-built lightsaber. I'm not too sure why they went for this transparent blue one instead of just a regular brown one like the rest of the sets. And then there's a dormitory build itself, which honestly I quite prefer to the common room build. Firstly, you get this really nice printed red book, which again on the inside does have a 1x1 tile, this time of a little potion spell. Then on the floor you get a ugly grey rat, which is I'm pretty sure meant to represent Scabbers. There's also a nice little teal blue little cabinet here with a door. Nothing is on the inside though, however you could always put the trunk in there if you really wanted to. Right on the top as well, sort of to match the backing of this set, is this little purple hat, which just sits on top of this really abstract sort of looking flower stud piece. And then last but not least, there is this build for the beds, which comes with this really big red cloth piece in order to sort of represent the beds here, which I thought was really cool. And also on the inside, there's another cloth piece, which is this weird sort of fluffy yellow fabric. I guess this is meant to sort of represent like a blanket or a mattress or something. But overall, it just feels a tiny bit weird. The build for this bed is really simple. I mean, you've got some arch pieces in order to sort of make it look like a tall bed. You've got those weird flower pieces again for the feet as well as to just sort of hook this piece of fabric on the top. And overall, just like the common room build, it's incredibly simple and I guess it works, but it doesn't really give you much space to actually play around with. So overall, this set is pretty neat and pretty interesting. I'm not surprised though that they did not continue on after this initial wave. I just feel like it's something that not too many people are interested in. I mean, it's Hogwarts, but it's built with like bright orange and pinks and purples. And even then, I also feel like this was just an attempt to really get some of the girls into buying Lego, because at the time, we'd sort of had things like Belleville, I'm pretty sure, and Clickets was still a few years off. So Lego was really trying to bring in a new audience, but I feel like it just wasn't enough sort of having orange and pink and purple. Like, you need to supply people with a tiny bit more content, as this set compared to a lot of other ones for the time just does not really have that. But in saying it, it is an incredibly unique and just interesting set to have in my collection, and I'm incredibly grateful for having this. I think it is so funny and just interesting, and there's a lot of really cool parts as well in it. But if you're looking for some older Harry Potter sets, I feel like unless you are interested in like really unique and kooky and just abstract sort of things, probably wouldn't put this one at the top of your list of things to buy. But let me know what you guys think about these sets in the comments down below, and if you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing down below for more Harry Potter content and reviews. And until next time guys, I'll see you later.